till my bones collapse. Hi guys, this is the Footians here. Welcome to our new video. In this video, we are going to show you guys how to implement tiki-taka, the pass and play style in FIFA 19. Let's get started. So first, I'm going to pick a team randomly to show you guys the formation, the tactics and the instructions suitable for this kind of play. So as you can see, I've taken Bayern. So the formation you have to choose is 4-2-3-1 narrow. Now I know you guys have seen Barcelona implement tiki-taka in real life with 4-3-3 formation, but this is FIFA and we've got to make some changes. I've selected narrow because it reduces the space between the players, making the pass and play tactic easier and efficient. So let me just make a few changes to the players, my starting 11. Now let's get started with the new FIFA 19 tactics. You obviously need to apply constant pressure when you're defending, so I'm setting the defending style as constant pressure. We can definitely afford some width during the time we're defending. Let the depth be as it is. And the offensive style will obviously be possession play because it's tiki-taka and that's what you do. So during an offensive period, that is when we are attacking, we obviously need to reduce the width because it creates more room for passing. The rest of the attributes doesn't affect the play that much, so it's your wish. So the strikers and the attacking midfielders should always stay forward no matter what. They shouldn't come back for defending. And the striker must get behind. He must make forward runs behind the defense. Doesn't matter if he's slow or fast. It's better if the holding midfielders stay back during the attack. The fullbacks must join the attack, typical Barcelona style. You know what? One holding midfielder can come forward to attack because that also increases the room for pass and play during the offensive periods. So here's my gameplay with these tactics. So press L1 and X if you're a PS user or LB and A if you're an Xbox user to pass the ball, because that helps you to make the forward runs. As you can see, absolutely no possession by the opponents. And oh, offside. So since Isco scored from the rebound, it's pretty obvious that it was offside. But yeah, you get the idea from my gameplay. Here's a few more. Remember, the passes don't always have to be forward passes. You can always pass the ball back to the midfielder or the defender, so that when the opponent goes to press that player or put more pressure on him, your attacker gets a lot of free space. Typical Pep Guardiola style. Here's one with Bayern Munich. Make sure that both you and your player has good vision, because to implement tiki-taka, vision is a very important aspect. So instead of passing the ball to one of the attackers, I've passed the ball to Alaba, an unmarked defender, a fullback, which then resulted in a goal. Now here's a proper one with Real Madrid, a legitimate goal. Look at the players beautifully making their forward runs. These two players are having a private game themselves. Very common when you're implementing tiki-taka. And boom. That's it from us today, guys. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something out of it. If you did, please leave a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and share it to your friends. Thank you. And do leave your opinion in the comments.